faithful Christians that we are praying for. Blessed is our God, always now and forever, into the ages of ages.
Amen.
O Lord, hear my prayer. Give ear to my supplication in your truth. Hear me in your righteousness. Do not enter into judgment with your servant, for in your sight no living is justified. For the enemy hath persecuted my soul, he has crushed my life to the ground. He hath made me dwell in the darkness like those who have long been dead. For my spirit is overwhelmed within me, my heart within me is distressed. I remember the days of old and meditated on all your works. I pondered on the work of your hand. I spread out my hands to you, my soul longs for you like a thirsty man. Hear me quickly, O Lord, my spirit fails. Do not turn your face away from me, lest I may be like those who go down to the pit. Cause me to hear your words in the morning, for in you I put my trust. Cause me to know, O Lord, the way in which I should walk, for I lift up my soul to you. Rescue me, O Lord, from my enemies. To you have I fled for refuge. Teach me to do your work, and you are my God. Your good spirit shall lead me in the land of uprightness, for your name's sake, O Lord, you shall keep me in your righteousness. You shall bring my soul out of trouble, and in your mercy you shall have me from my enemy. And you shall destroy all those who afflict my soul, for I am your servant.
God is the Lord who has revealed himself to us. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Give thanks to the Lord and call upon his holy name.
Deus quini, Deus quem et fanem.
Thank you.
most holy Theotokos, save us. With man and temptation surrounding me, searching for salvation, I have hastened unto O Mother of the Word and ever Virgin, from all distresses and dangers deliver me. Fervently we cry to you, Theotokos, our name. Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. We are thankful for all the gifts which we have been given by you, the spotless one. And to you we sing a hymn of praise, knowing you to be the Mother of God.
Except for you, who are the bride.
capaz mi absurda lambrimete, indria di chi monadi iero che fio.
Through the intercessions of the most pure Lady, the Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary,
By the power of the precious light, created for us the protection of the marvelous powers of heaven, supplication now, O glorious prophet and forerunner, John the Baptist, the holy, glorious, and praiseworthy apostles of our fathers, and all the saints, the great high arts and ecumenical teachers, days of the great critical theologian and our first system, Athanasius and Cyril, the merciful patriarchs of Alexandria, Nicholas, Bishop of Lemire, the CS, Spirit, Bishop of Demetrius, the wonder workers of the holy, glorious, great martyrs, George, victorious, Demetrius, the merciful, theater of the recruit, theater of the general, of the holy higher martyrs, Arabos and Ephthadius, of the holy glorious prophet martyrs, of the venerable God, the ascetic father, of the holy righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, of St. Ephesianus, the martyr of Antioch, the righteous father, Evgeny, of Athenos, of Ephesianus, patriarch of Constantinople, Christos, the new prison, Revedis, Oswald, the martyr of the king of Northumbria, we commemorate today and of all the saints. We beseech you, O merciful Lord, hear us, sinners, and pray to you, and have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Thank you.
glad is filled my heart, most holy Virgin Lady, for you are she who received the abundant joy. Take the grief of my sinfulness and make it disappear. Thank you. Spirit, now and forever, to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Come quickly, let come, let us all welcome the transfiguration of Christ, and joyously celebrate the bright festival. O ye faithful, and let us cry, now near is at near at hand, now is the day of God-given gladness, as the sovereign master goes up on Mount Tabor, to flash forth with the beautiful light of his divinity. Glory to the Father, to the Son, to the Holy Spirit, your martyr, O Lord, in his courageous contest for you, received as the prize that crowns of incorruption and life from you, our immortal God. For since he possessed your strength, he cast down the tyrants and wholly destroyed the demon's strengthless presumption. O Christ, our God, by his mercy, your souls, since you are merciful, look now forever and unto the ages of ages. Amen. We know you, the Word. We know the word of the Father, even Christ our God, to be incarnate of the Holy Virgin Theotokos, only pure one, only blessed one. Wherefore we magnify you and praise you unceasingly. Have mercy on us, O God, according to your great mercy. We pray to you, hear us, and have mercy. Of Constantinople, Christos, the new martyr, Prevezis, Oswald, the martyr king of Northumbria, whose memory we commemorate today, and of all the saints. Have mercy on us and save us, for he is a good and merciful God who loves mankind. I have maintained, brothers and sisters in Christ, I have maintained throughout my time here, and really throughout the church's life, that a feast is a feast is a feast is a feast. In other words, we feast. You know, when it's time to feast, we feast. And some feast means Some feasts mean that there's not really a festival. Like when we celebrate the beheading of John the Baptist, there's really no festival that takes place because it's a strict fast. We're celebrating a man that just lost his head. And we're celebrating in the way that he lived. In other words, we're not celebratory because he lost his head, even though we celebrate a martyr's death, and we truly celebrate in the truest way. When a martyr dies, because they have, you know, as St. Paul says, they have finished the race, you know, they completed the course, you know, and when you, as St. Paul says, that when you compete according to the rules, so to speak, you receive a prize, and we celebrate that prize that the martyrs receive. We receive these crowns, St. John the Baptist, my goodness, amazing, but we keep that day as a strict fast day. Why? Because he lived, he barely ate. On that day, that specific day, the day he died, the day that we commemorate when his head was severed from his body, we remember how he lived, and that's why we keep the strict fast. So not every feast is the same kind of feast, but it's a feast. So the feast of and even though that's sometimes listed among the 12, sometimes not listed among the 12 great feasts, it depends on who's calculating the list, you know, we still celebrate it as a feast. The other feast that bears in mind where there is a strict fast day associated on the day of the feast is when? You know? Remember? Strict fast day on the day, not before, but on the day. It's coming up. Feast of the Cross. No matter what day of the week it's on, it's a strict fast day. Okay? Even if it's on a Sunday, there is a fast associated with it. Even though it's not completely a strict fast day because it's a Sunday, still have wine, oil, and all the rest of these things. It is still, we reserve it as a strict fast day. Why? Because what are we remembering on that day? Yes, we're remembering that Helen found the cross, St. Helen found the true cross of Christ. We're remembering that on that day and how it was elevated. But we are fasting in thanksgiving. It's another way of looking at fasting. See, sometimes fasting is not meant in preparation. Sometimes we fast because we're thankful. I know it's kind of crazy to think of it that way. Because we think of fasting as like, oh, I'm fasting, I'm be mad and sad and down, I'm fasting. No, see, even Jesus says don't look like that. You know? It doesn't have to, we don't have to look like Eeyore, you know? We don't have to be like that. When he says when you fast, you're supposed to anoint your face. Look good. No one should ever know that you're fasting. But we fast on that day in a fast of thanksgiving. Because we didn't know what we were going to find when Helen came back to the cross. They were so overwhelmed with joy that they actually gave their fast as a sacrifice to the Lord. And we continue to keep that fast as a way of us remembering that day. So, why am I saying all this? Well, tomorrow's a feast. Not actually tomorrow. Tomorrow begins a feast. Okay? But, so when we have in the church, we have these feasts. And then sometimes after the feast, we have what's called the period of feasting. So sometimes after a feast, we don't just celebrate it on the day. We'll celebrate it on the day, and then we'll celebrate it for 3, 4, 5, 7 days. In the case of Pascha, 40 days later, we're still celebrating Pascha. So we have a period of time. And then 7 days after that period of time, depending on the feast, we'll have what's called the apodosis, or the after feast, the leave taking of the feast.
So it's almost like we're recreating the same feast over again. We're never done feasting. If we really let the cycle of the church, the way the church has given us the cycle of the services, if we really let the cycle of the church take us through the year, we're high, down, up, this, going here, whatever, and all of it is in the name of Christ. For people that are, kind of need to be even keeled, it's a little bit difficult, but eventually you find your stride. The church never takes you up too high. It really doesn't. The church never wants us to be too low. Even in our sinfulness, we're supposed to recognize it and not take us too low, because sometimes we're the ones doing that, not Christ. Sometimes. But not the feast, not the after feast, not the leave taking of the feast. Every once in a while we have what's called a forefeast. And that's where we are today. We are in the forefeast of the Transfiguration. We begin at sundown tonight, and we go until the feast begins tomorrow night at Vespers, the Feast of the Holy Transfiguration. And that's what this is. What is a forefeast? It's kind of like pregame warm-up. You know, it's like we're not there yet. You know, we're almost there. You know, why does the church create a forefeast? Why have we done this? Who writes the hymns of the church? Who writes them? I mean, does God come down and say, this is what you should write? No. And they're enlightened, certainly, and illumined by God. But it's our hymnographers. It's the people that have been given that text to write hymns. And why then do we have feasts of, why do we have days where we call it the forefeast of a certain feast? Because those individuals who were writing these hymns recognized two things. Number one, they recognized there was a feast coming. And number two, they were excited about it. They were jazzed, man. They were ready. They were ready to get this feast on, man. I want this to come now. Think about Pascha, right? We're getting close to Easter, right? And we're getting there. And all of a sudden, Palm Sunday rolls around. What happens? The church entirely changes in color. It goes to purple and goes down, and we're here, and we have all of these things leading up, service after service after service. What did we say? 28 services, I think we counted this year. 28 services in a period of 1 week, gearing up for Pascha. Unbelievable. This is what the church does when it really anticipates something with great joy. That's what a forefeast is. And the 5th of August, not the 6th, the 6th is the Feast of the Holy Transfiguration. The 5th of August, of which we have just kicked off by our service this evening, even though it's technically still before. The 5th of August, we celebrate a forefeast. And it's not the only one we're going to celebrate. There's one more coming. In just a week, we're going to celebrate another forefeast before the Prohibition. Father speaking of the Blessed Mother of the Virgin Mary. We're going to celebrate that forefeast as well. But this forefeast we're celebrating in a specific way so that we can gear ourselves up for it. It's the way the church is letting us know, hey, wake up, there's church. Now we have one calls and emails and things that we send out. Hey, there's a feast coming. We don't necessarily utilize the means of the church any longer to remind ourselves. But the means by which the church reminded the people, its people, that there was a feast coming, it hasn't changed. The church needs to remind ourselves, needs to remind each other, hey, oh my goodness, you're coming to church just because it's church, and all of a sudden you hear Holy Transfiguration on tape, or, oh, it's coming. I better get ready. For some people, that's cleanse my soul. For other people, I've already done that, let's get grapes. Because that's what we do on Transfiguration, right? That we bless grapes. So God, through the church, is reminding us of these blessed days. Let's take the moment. Let's take the call. Let's not scream this one. Let's not put this one over on the side and say, what is the church doing? What is the church telling them? Gear up in our minds and in our hearts to hear the words that are being said to us this evening. The Feast of Holy Transfiguration is coming. It's blessed, actually, that it's coming on a Sunday, so some people may just experience it just because it's Sunday. But others may actually know and prepare themselves appropriately. You have that opportunity. Today, we begin our preparation of the Transfiguration of Christ. Sunday, we will offer it completely in the Divine Liturgy. Tomorrow evening, we will celebrate it with great joy and Vespers. But we have the opportunity now to do this. So let us take that opportunity with great love and great joy and finish this service as a reminder of our prayer before the Lord and as a reminder of His feast where He has revealed Himself to us. That's what we said at the beginning of the service. So we're going to have this opportunity to come and bless the icon. You will notice, notice that as you venerate the icon this evening, our Blessed Mother has given us a nice remembrance that she's with us. And you'll see it as you venerate the icon. She's not fragrant, but you'll see where she has decided to remind us that she's here and she's with us. So that's a blessing too. And then I've left the cross out, but this is the last day it will be left out. I'll be taking it back in after the service this evening. So you can venerate the icon, venerate the cross, and I'll be over here blessing everyone with the same myrrh that is streaming down the side of me. So we'll be blessed with that as well. Okay? Please rise, and we will finish. Thank you. Through the prayers of Holy Fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.
Amen.
May the Holy Trinity bless, protect, and keep, and be with all of you. As I mentioned before, tomorrow night is Vespers of Holy Transfiguration. Those Vespers will not happen here because we have a church in the city of Steubenville that is Orthodox that celebrates the Holy Transfiguration. So we're going to go there, which is the OCA Church up on the hill. And Vespers, Great Vespers, will happen at 6 o'clock tomorrow night at Holy Transfiguration Church up on the hill as you're going up Washington Street. You kind of cut up and we'll be there. 6 o'clock tomorrow night for Great Vespers of Holy Transfiguration. There will be, I'm actually not presiding, there will be a priest for the OCA Church there, which hasn't happened, consistently in a while, but it's their feast day, so the bishop is blessing it. I don't believe the bishop is going to come. He will be there on Sunday for their feast day. He'll actually liturgize at that church on Sunday, which is a huge blessing and joy. But at the very least, there's this young priest named Father Esteban, and he will be there. And if you want to hear a really, really learned Orthodox priest, you have to hear this man. He's very, very wise. So please come, because on Sunday you won't hear the bishop preach Father Esteban. So come tomorrow night if you'd like to hear it. It's a wonderful joy and blessing to have such good things happening for us. And again, Sunday we will have liturgy here and blessings of the grapes and all of those things that will take place. All right? God bless. May the Lord be with you, and may He give you, and may Panagia also give you peace and protection during this time. Continue your struggle, please.